Welcome to the Mischief. I'm Valen, and this is Immersive Engineering. Today I'm going to be covering the feed-through insulator, the new kinds of cables that you can make and how they function, plus a little bit on how cables and wires now change how they work. Ah, lovely day out here on my deck. So, if I go into my workshop here, I've got cables, right? You notice that some of them are actually white. I don't know if you are one of those that are watching, typically to, part of the play-through series or the bit-by-bit series I have on Immersive Engineering. I'm going to try and keep this as short and sweet as possible. So the cables or wires in Immersive Engineering have changed how they work. It's similar, but not exactly the same. So there's still low voltage, medium voltage, high voltage, etc. But there are now some new versions of those. There's the insulated low voltage and the insulated medium voltage. If I change my game mode to survival mode here, you'll notice that I have a full health bar, right? Well, watch what happens if I walk into this LV cable. Previously, I'd just walk right through it. Nothing would happen. Now I take a heart of damage. If I go past the insulated LV, nothing happens. If I'm close to a connector and I pass the insulated LV, you might still take some damage. That's because it's still close to the LV cable over here. So keep that in mind that even if it connects to a connector or relay, there still is like a little area that it's going to be a bit more dangerous. Now, if I go into the insulated MV cable over here, of course, I'm not going to take any damage from that. But if I walk up to the regular MV cable, I'll take a couple hearts, and you'll notice that I got pushed back a little bit on one and a little bit more on the other, etc. So if I go into the HV cable, there is no insulated version. So you're probably going to want to convert stuff if you want to keep it a little bit safer around your base. But now if I walk into it, watch my hearts. Ow! 7 hearts of damage. And this is without armor. And I got knocked back really far. That's like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5.5 blocks, something like that. And if I put armor on, and I walk back in, let me actually have a little nom. I go up here, I take a lot less damage. And people are probably wondering, well, what happens if I wear a Faraday suit, you know? Yeah, you still die. And then people might think, well, if I'm wearing a Faraday suit, it's good against low voltage stuff, right? With the Tesla coil, and no, you'll still take a little bit of damage. You know, you'll still get the hit and the zap from it. This is not Tesla electricity. This is dangerous cables that are exposed, things that you don't want to worry about, you know, so let's get rid of that. Now, keep in mind, of course, pour water on these, nothing's really going to happen. But also the way that the cables connect to each other have changed. So if I take some LV cable here, run over to this connection here, you'll notice, what is this? The connection is obstructed and a block is lit red. What the heck is that? That's part of the new things that go on with Immersive Engineering. You can't really connect blocks through walls anymore. And even if I could, let's say I put a connector here and then I connect these two together, there's not enough sag for it to actually interfere with anything. And then if I grab a block here and place it down, oh, the coil breaks. So you previously you could put these in the way afterwards, and then you'd be able to use that cable or coil. But since then, it has been changed. Things are a bit different. So you're going to have to improvise with something new. This here, if you notice, a feed-through insulator. That's how I have power currently going into my little house here, which is powering this light. As you can see here, I can turn this on and off. There you go. And that pretty much will allow me to do so. And I can do, you know, the same out here. Turn the light, which you can see through the window there, on and off, and so on. Now, a feed-through insulator in the book, in your manual, is, well, in my opinion, not exactly clear on how to make it. So if I take a block, a mundane block. It can be something a little bit more interesting, but if you take something too complex, like an entity or a furnace or something like that, you might have some difficulty. And you take some kind of connectors. You can use redstone connectors. You can also use something like, let's grab this. Not the feed-through insulator, my bad. you can grab a regular connector like this here, LV connector. But most connectors should work, LV, MV, HV, so on. Now, in order to actually make this work so that you can transmit power from one side to the other, All right, so in this example, I currently have a grass block with a couple of LV wire connectors on it, a powered lantern that is currently off, and a capacitor. So if I take some LV wire, which, yes, it is slightly dangerous, but not too bad. I'm not going to walk into it, so no damage is going to be done. Connect this to this, and connect this to this. You'd think, all right, well, that why isn't it powering it? Because you actually have to do something to this block in order for it to properly work. Now, if you aim at this little gray area of the connector, or in the case of a redstone wire connector, it would be just a little red tip on there. Shift, right click, it should work, but it's not, because you actually need to have it disconnected from wires before you can do this. You're creating a multi-block structure out of these three blocks. So if I do that, you'll notice it changed. It kind of set this into it, and it is now a single block, which is actually pretty darn cool. So if I take some LV wire coil, and I then reconnect everything here to here, and here to here. Oh, my bad. There we go. It then will connect properly. I had to actually connect from this one to that one. Sometimes it doesn't like going from the end connector to it. But you can see it now allows you to transmit power through the block. And then you can always, of course, you know, use your engineer wire cutters on the feed-through insulator ends to cut the wire. If you use a pick, you then get a unique block, a feed-through insulator. And no, I'm not in creative. And then you can actually place it down again. And whichever direction that you actually place it, it's actually going to face kind of parallel to you. So if I want this to be the way it was, I need to kind of be facing in this direction, and so on. And that's pretty much it. Basically, bare wires are dangerous now. You're going to want to insulate them, which insulating them, for example, an LV wire coil versus an insulated LV wire coil. The insulated LV wire coil adds a bunch of tough fabric to the recipe. So you do those and you basically are wrapping it in tough fabric. Same thing with MV wire and insulated MV, but you're going to need some creosote on top of that in order to make that a little bit more resilient to the higher voltage. And as a reminder, there is no HV insulation. You're just going to have to be careful. Keep it up off the ground or in hidden areas. And this should allow you to, I don't know, better adapt your setup. I hope you guys enjoyed. There's not much else to the update. There's a lot of fixes that have been going out. So if you guys enjoyed, be sure to give a like, comment, subscribe. And as always, don't be afraid to spread the mischief to others if you think that they'll enjoy this content too. And until next time, folks, I'll see you.